Is there anybody here waiting on the Lord today? Come on, are you sensing something in this room? Come on, our pastor has taught us that expectation is the breeding ground of your miracle. Come on, Valor, make some noise. Come on, lift your voice right now. Begin to give God the fruit of your lips. I heart, we welcome you right there where you are. Begin to lift those hands as high as you can. Begin to praise your God. This is the day, come on, that the Lord has made. Did anybody come in here to rejoice and be glad in it? Is there any radical praisers in here today? Is there any worshipers in the room today? Come on, are you ready to take another dip? No. Are you ready to take another dip into his glory, into his presence? Come on, stir that gift that is within you. Stir that gift that is within you. Tell your body, tell your mind to line up with whatever the Lord is going to do. Father, we welcome you today. We glorify you today. Open up the windows of heaven and pour on us. Get those hands up. Begin to praise your God. Begin to shout hallelujah. Begin to say glory to God. Begin to move in this place. Come on. Come on, worshipers. Come on, praisers. Come on, out of your belly will flow rivers of living water. Come on, swoo. Hey, here we are, God. Here we are, God. We need you today. We want you today. All the Jesus fanatics, all the Jesus freaks, begin to praise your God. Woo, come on, I feel an upper room experience in here today. Woo, I feel an upper room experience in here today. I said we are about to have an upper room experience in here today. God, we've been waiting for you. You promised us that if we will wait on you, you would come visit us and you would endue us with power. That's it, God. We need your power. God, we want your power. God, we're not moving here without your power. We're not gonna stop shouting until we feel power. We're not gonna stop worshiping until we sense your glory. We're not gonna stop praying until we have more. Come on, Valor. I'm telling you, this is a different day. This is a different day. This is a different hour. This is a different moment. Come on and praise him now. Come on and glorify him now. Wave until you capture God's attention. Come on, I heard. You're not left out. God has something for you. The heavens are about to open right there where you are. Come on, come on, press in. Hey. Press in. Come on, worship him. Come on, glorify him. Magnify his name. until you feel your mind change. Praise Him until you get your first love back. Praise Him until you can feel what you're reaching for. Praise Him. Take another dip. Take another dip. Hey, hey, that's it. Now, hey. Woo. Take another dip. 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 I don't care if you are an instructor or a pastor or a minister. This is our day too. Get those hands up. Lead by example. Let's break ourselves in the glory. Distract you. Close your eyes and worship Him. Come on, press. Push. Move yourself out the way. That's it, honey. Cry. That's it, sir. Cry. Yourself, put yourself. I hear you, Pastor Brandon Clark. Put yourself back on His potter's wheel so He can shape you again, mold you again, fix you again, change you again, act to you again.
Watching on iHeart.tv and even those in Elkhart that might be watching, thank you for tuning in with us this morning. Yesterday when Valor Grad Pastor Brian Gallardo was preaching and he was talking about the saturation, and I was reminded that the saturation comes at a cost. You just can't be saturated and think you can go back to your old ways and then come back and sprinkle and then go back and sprinkle. No, it comes at a cost. So I was reminded, you know, God has been putting 1 Samuel on my heart this week, and I messaged Miss Ashton yesterday and was just like, I feel this word and I feel like it's for tomorrow before we get baptized, before we go into a new season, and she released me to say it today, so I just want to share it with you. I want to read you the whole message because also some of you, God has placed the word on your heart, but you don't know the right way to go about, you know, delivering it or going about the way with leadership. So I want to read the whole message to you. I said, Miss Ashton, there has been a word on my heart for the past few days now, and I believe it's for the student body as we step into something new tomorrow. I submit under your leadership and know that you will do as the Holy Spirit leads. But whether you release the word or not, I know I'm supposed to tell you, so I'm just being obedient. Excuse me. I said, Hannah Barron gets provoked by her rival Penina because she cannot give birth. Hannah, who is not walking out in her call and destiny, is getting provoked by someone who is walking in their call. A lot of you are watching people lead worship, preach powerfully, minister to the sick, etc., and you're asking God, why not me? I know you've called me, why not me now? And if you only knew that the seed inside of you is that of a firstborn and receives a double portion. If you only knew that what I have placed inside of you is called for a specific generation. Your voice is called to reach a specific people. Not everyone is your people. We then see Hannah bow before the Lord, and she mourns and says, Lord, if you give me a son, I will give him to you for the rest of his life. It wasn't until then that God released her womb. For some of you, God is requiring you to give it to him before he can give it to you. God is requiring him, you to give it to him before he can give it to you. What he has placed on the inside of you is so big. You wonder how you're going to do it. You wonder how you're going to carry it out. But Abba Father is saying today, I haven't intended for you to carry it. I intended for you to walk with me and allow me to carry it, and I will carry you. So just be reminded, he wants you to give it to him. Give it to him so that he can give it to you. It's so big, guys. It's so big. You know it. Don't second guess. I'm going to use Janae as an example. A lot of you worshipers see Janae up here worshiping, and she's new, right? She's a part of us, but she's a new student. Just because she's new, don't look at her as if, oh, you know, I'm second best. I've served. I've been here long enough. I've cried. No, God has given your gift, the seed inside of you, for a specific generation, a specific people. Don't think that you're not as good as somebody else leading or praying or pushing. Thank you, Father God. RG.
It's time to praise God. No, I thought I was gonna get a little bit more anticipation. It's time to praise our God. Okay, I'm gonna try this side. It's time to praise our God. iHeart, it is time to praise our God. Let's get ready to go. Come on, shout right now and let's praise our God.
Come on, are you ready to lift high the name of Jesus today? Come on, shout amen if you believe it. Hey, 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 hey. Come on, let's jump together. Hallelujah, praise you, Jesus. Come on, let's declare this. Say you turned
it all. Where I was hurting, now I'm to Jesus. Or I'm looking for some radical folk that's planted by the tree of living waters, right? Come on, put your hands together like this.
Woo! There is a river where goodness flows. There is a fountain that drowns sorrows. There is an ocean deeper than fear. The tide is rising, rising. Woo! There is a current stirring deep inside. It's overflowing from the heart of God, the flood of heaven crashing over.
break open prison doors. Woo! Set all the captives free. Spring up a well. Spring up a well. Spring up a well in me. Break open prison doors. Not just for me, but for someone in Africa. Set all the captives free. Not all for me, but someone in my family. Spring up a well. Spring up a well. Spring up a well, spring up a well in me. Come on, you say it. Break open prison doors. Come on, set your family free. I feel Jesus this morning. I said, I feel Jesus this morning. Father, we ask for your Holy Spirit to come.
Oh, come on, lift up your hands today. It says that if you seek him with your whole heart, you will find him. We seek after you this morning, Father.
Your presence.
We seek, we ask, we fire. We bid you come like fire. Sing that with me. We bid you come like fire. We bid you come all like consuming fire.
We bid you come like fire.
No. We bid you come like fire.
We bid you come like fire.
Show your God.
We bid you come like fire.
Yeah. We bid you come like fire. We bid you come like rain.
No.
We bid you come like fire. We bid you come like rain.
No.
We bid you come like thunder. We bid you come. Like fire, we bid you come like rain. We bid you come in power, fill our hearts again. We bid you come like thunder, come like wind. We bid you come in power, fill our hearts again.
John 7, 37 through 39. Now on the last day, the great day of the feast, Jesus stood and cried, saying, "If any man thirst, let him come unto me and drink. He that believeth on me, as the scripture hath said, from within him shall flow rivers of living water. But this spake he of the Spirit, which they that believed on him were to receive. For the Spirit was not yet given, because Jesus was not yet glorified." Kayla shared that scripture with me earlier today. It was part of her devotion. And when I went and I asked her, "Well, what was that scripture again?" She gave it to me and she said, "Here's what I got out of that. It says that the Spirit, they were to receive the Spirit. It was the will of God that they receive the Spirit. But it says that they had not yet received the Spirit because Jesus had not yet been glorified." So Kayla said, "What I get out of that, Miss Ashton, is we can't receive the glory and we can't receive the full manifestation of the Spirit to the point where rivers of living water flow out of us until we have first glorified Him." So we may be taking a little bit of time this morning, but we're all to receive the Spirit today. Whether you're going down in that watery grave and coming up free and delivered or not, whether you've been baptized before or not, we're all to receive the Spirit today. It's to be manifested in our lives in a new and in a fresh way, but until we glorify Jesus, until he is yet glorified, we cannot receive the full manifestation of the glory of God. We have to glorify him first to receive the glory. And so I want us to continue to sing this, and I want us to continue to worship. And when Pastor Manny feels released, he'll come up and he's going to teach you a little bit about water baptism and what that means. And then we'll give you instruction and we'll get to that. But first, we need to spend just a little more time glorifying God. And I'm going to put her on the spot, but I know she doesn't care. Evie, I'm going to ask that you come up here. Bring your flags and come on up. You know, we believe in government around here. Our pastor teaches us that without government, you cannot have glory. Without glory, there's no government. Goes hand in hand. And so you students are so gracious when we instruct you to operate in government. You know, you all worship so beautifully with your flags, and we ask that in order to not be distracting to those at the altar, you worship in that way, you know, off to the side. Just so cameras, we're not in the way of cameras knocking people down or whatever. And Evie's been so gracious to do that. But I stand here in this gully every service, and so I can see everything and I watch her. And it doesn't matter that she's not down here and that she's not up here. It doesn't matter if she's way back there in that corner in the dark all by herself. But she gives glory to God with all of her strength and with all of her might. And even though we may not see her, God sees her. She performs for an audience of one. And that's what matters today in this moment. Right now, you have captured the attention of heaven. What a thought, what a revelation, what a privilege, what an honor that all of heaven is looking over the sapphire sill of those pearly gates and saying, look at them, watch them glorify my God. Watch them glorify the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. They're desperate for his presence. They're desperate for more of him. And so we're just going to do that right now. And Evie's just going to lead us in worship. But you worship in your own way right there where you are. Before an audience of one, glorify him with all your strength and with all your might. Come on right now, open up your mouth. Open up your mouth and glorify God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
We bid you come like fire. We bid you come like rain. We bid you come in power. Fill our hearts again. We bid you come like thunder. We bid you come like wind. We bid you come in
presence. Oh, we want your presence. Say, Holy Spirit, come.
The spirit of prophecy is about to hit this place. I feel Jesus in this room right now. I feel the glory of heaven all around us. I just can't help but just proclaim the goodness of God. Come on, somebody just help me. Don't let me be by myself. Somebody just begin to tell him how good he is. Somebody just begin to tell him how faithful he is. Come on, I feel Jesus in this house right now. If it had not been for the Lord by my side, where? Some of you about to shift yourself out of the muck and the mire. Some of you about to walk into purpose. Some of you about to walk into destiny. The promise that God gave 35 years ago is about to come to fruition now. If you would lift up the glory. Somebody magnify the King of Kings. Somebody just let him know right now how good he is. Come on, somebody, out of your trial, out of your tribulation, out of your mess, just begin to let him know. If it hadn't been for your grace, if it hadn't been for your mercy.
Come on.
See, I don't know if you realize this yet or not, but you just came to the happiest funeral you've ever attended. No, maybe some people right here. I said you just came to the happiest funeral you've ever attended. Let me talk to somebody who's been through some mess over here. I said, you're about to attend the happiest funeral you've ever attended. Here's the reason why. Some things that have come to kill, steal, and destroy are about to die in the water. When you go under, something's about to transpire in your life. There's about to be a promotion take place. You're about to go from glory to glory. You just came to the happiest funeral you've ever been to. So why don't you just get happy for about 15 seconds and give God some praise, because he's about to take you to the next level. I hear the word of the Lord say, today's a day of promotion. Today's a day of promotion. Possession, the highest form of faith that you can give back to God is praising him before it happens. Woo! Giving him a sacrifice of praise. Giving a little thanksgiving while you're still in the thick of it. So I believe before we ever even get started in this baptism service, I think we need to get ourselves in a position where we flex the muscle of faith called thanksgiving and begin to thank him. That lust, that abuse that runs rampant in my mind and plagues me in the midnight hour, the identity that I've allowed myself to take on is no longer going to be a part of my future. I just need somebody right now just to praise God for what he's about to do in this house. Come on, I need you to shout. I need you to jump. I need you to leap. I need you to flex your faith. Because you're free from homosexuality. Spin, because depression dies today.
Don't wait till the battle is over. Don't
you. I came in here today to bring you to breakthrough. Breakthrough begins where your excuses end. I'm going to say that again because I think somebody needs to be delivered of excuses. I said breakthrough begins where your excuses end. Stop making excuses. I came from the wrong side of the tracks. Stop making excuses. I'm not talented enough. I'm not good enough. Stop making excuses and allow the glory of... today, but you just might as well go ahead and result yourself to them clothes getting all wet, because I'm telling you, you're about to take another dip, and when you get up out of that water, everything changes. I'm telling you, someone's about to break loose in this place, Miss Ashton. I'm telling you, we're about to prophesy like we've never seen before. We're about to call things, and it's not going to take years for it to come to existence. It's about to manifest same day. I want a FedEx kind of anointing all my life. Same day delivery. I don't want to wait. I want to speak to the mountain and then see that mountain begin to be removed. And in order for us to get to that place, we got to go through a thing called process. We got to submit ourselves to the working of Christ on the inside. That's why we came in this place today. Not so we can look cute and show off. We came to this place so that we can die. Die to self. Die to want. Die to everything we thought we were in. I don't want you to lose what God's doing in here right now, so just stay with me, just stay with me, stay with me. I'm not going to take long. I'm not going to take long. We're going to get somewhere. First thing I want to teach you this morning is this. iHeart.tv, we're so glad you're with us. Just thank the gift of God in this house and the founder, Dr. Rod Parsley. I would not be who I am today if it wasn't for his investment into my life. And every day I wake up and I'm thankful that God has given me a not just a mentor, not just a preacher, but a father. And Pastor, I honor you and I thank you for everything that you've done and everything you're about to do, because I believe this. Greater things are about to come. Seven-time greater anointing. Seven-time greater anointing. Seven-time greater anointing.
I'm going to do what I've learned to do best from our pastor, and that is to flow in the Spirit. Now, Pastor Manny has prepared a teaching for us about baptism and what it means and all of that, and that's wonderful, and we need that, and we'll hear it later on. But right now, the waters are troubled, literally and figuratively. And I do not want to, there is a window and a portal open right now, and I don't want us to miss this moment. This moment, all right? So, here's your instruction, okay? Ladies, this side. Gentlemen, this side, all right? Pastor Manny is gonna go on up with Pastor RD, get themselves ready and prepared. Take your towels up there with you. All of the items that you need in order to change afterward and such. If you forgot a towel, we have one. If you've decided in the last 30 to 3 minutes that you want to get baptized today, honey, you better run like a gazelle on over to the dormitories, get you some all black or all dark clothing to wear, get you a towel and some clothes to change into, and come running back here. Nobody is left out today. please, please heed Miss Charisse's instructions. Miss Charisse is in charge of the baptistry along with Dr. Courtner. Please heed their instructions as well as any other leadership that's present. For those of you that are not getting baptized, this is not a time to spectate, all right? We'll give them a few minutes to get themselves situated, but we're gonna come. You can catch your breath and take a drink of water or whatever. Wipe the sweat off your brow if you have to, but we're gonna fill this altar again in just a few moments. And the praise team's gonna stay and the band's gonna stay because, as Pastor Manny said, this is about to be the happiest funeral you've ever attended. We're gonna praise and we're gonna celebrate this prophetic and significant moment in the lives of these students. Baptism is second only to salvation. It's second only to salvation. It is a requirement. Even Jesus Christ of Nazareth himself was baptized. That ought to signify the importance. It is a sign and a confirmation of your complete and total surrender to God the Father, the Holy Spirit, Jesus Christ, three in one. Around here, we baptize in all three, all right? People like to get caught up in all that religiosity and doctrine and theology. Look, so we just take care of all of it. We baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit around here, all right? Because it's all the three in one, all right? So we've got you covered. But when we look at that water, we look at it as a watery grave. Pastor Manny already said it. When you go down into that watery grave, everything that's on you, in you, around you that ain't supposed to be there, it's killed. It's dead. It's gone. It's buried. It stays there in that watery grave. And when you get up, it ain't coming back up with you. When you come up out of that water, you are walking, you are saturated, you are literally saturated in freedom, in healing, in deliverance, in peace, in joy. There's breakthrough in that water. There's breakthrough in that water. And I'm so proud and I'm so thankful for all of the students that answered the call and the mandate to get water baptized today. And then after that, we're gonna get endued, or as our pastor said on Sunday, infused with a power from on high. Elder Germain prophesied it earlier. We're about to have an upper room experience. I'm not gonna get into all the Bible about it. Look it up, all right? But after you have been baptized in water, if you have not yet been baptized in the Spirit with the evidence of speaking in tongues, today is your day. Are y'all hearing me up there? Today is your day. Today is your day. This is divine appointment. Why are the lights not on up there? What are we doing? Why are the lights not on? What's happening? Somebody that knows what they're doing, turn the lights on up there, please. Let me see my camera shot, Sarah. There we go. Look at that. Look at that. There's our Director of Student Ministries and Valor Christian College graduate, Pastor Artie Smith, along with our chaplain and Valor Christian College graduate and World Harvest Church Elkhart Campus Pastor, Manny Gonzalez. Amen. Give me a high sign if we're ready to go up there. We got the high sign. All right. So let's all stand that are here. Let's come down to the altar. Elder Germain is going to lead us in this portion of the service. And Pastor Brian Gallardo, who tore this place up and set the atmosphere last night with a message called Take a Dip. He didn't know how prophetic he was being. He is here with us. And if at any one point you want to get up, you are released to do that. Valor Christian College graduate, Pastor Gallardo. I'm going to go up there and watch my kids be changed and transformed right in front of my eyes. Amen.
Come on, Valor. Get in here real close right here. Come on. Get in here real close. close. Come on, just for the next couple of moments while Pastor Manny and Pastor RD is getting whomever ready, stretch your hands this way right now and release fire on that water. Y'all missed it. Come on, release fire on that water right now. Father, in the name of Jesus, glory to God, I thank you right now that, Father, that Pastor Manny and RD is experiencing the spirit of prophecy. And God, right before they put those men and women under that water, give them a life-changing word that will set them on fire. Father, we're thankful that when they go down, everything that's been on their back, every oppressing, every depressing, every demonic spirit is about to be drowned in the water. Come on, y'all, push. I said every demonic spirit is about to be drowned. And when they come up out of that water, I thank you that they're coming up having a Holy Ghost fit. Shout right now. Come on. Scream right now. Come on, come on. Is that Jackie? Come on, let's pray right now that when she goes down, she's coming up with a word. She's coming up with vision. She's coming up with... Shout now! Stretch your hands. Come on, stretch your hands. Hey! Hey! Come on, something's turning. Something's moving. Something's shaking.
Jump up and down.
anointing, breakthrough, the destroying of yokes and the lifting of burdens, the destroying of yokes and the lifting of burdens, destroying yokes and lifting burdens.
B-A-A-K-K. Sexual purity is being restored. Every lady, I want you right now. Sexual purity is being restored in the name of Jesus. Every young man, every bit of molestation and abuse that has taken place, you're about to be restored in the name of Jesus. Everybody watching on iHeart.tv, lift your hands. Go get a glass of water. Go get something. There is a new day for you right now. I tell you right now, life springs forth in the name of Jesus.
Something is.
Let me prophesy for a minute. You don't stand here just for yourself. I mean, you're going to get a 7 times greater anointing for yourself because of your obedience. But you are standing here, standing in the gap for your church, your churches, and your city. I am telling you that when you go down into this water, overlording spirits that are tormenting your city, are going to die in that watery grave, and a new mantle is going to come up out of there with you. For souls. More souls in the next 6 months than you have seen in your last 20 years of ministry. More miracles, more signs, more wonders, more healings, more testimonies, more souls, more converts in the next 6 months than you have seen in the last 20 years. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Baptize him, Manny. Baptize him, RD.
Everybody, everybody shout right now! Hey, hey! That dance, Pastor Galato! Dance, sir! Dance in your new anointing! Dance in your new anointing! Everybody shout right now! It's getting ready to happen! second wave.
Something's new. Something's changed. 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 Something's new
see you wave your hand.
then she goes down in the water. Okay, listen. Listen. I just heard the Lord say this, that this service has become an activation service. That he's about to activate the gifts of the Holy Ghost within us. The gifts of the Holy Ghost is about to be activated within us. Now, this ain't for everybody. And that's okay, because all of us may not be able to operate in that. But for those that have been secretly praying for, run down here to this altar. Run down here. You've been praying that you will move in the gifts of the Holy Ghost. Don't be ashamed. Listen, the gift of faith doesn't mean you're a prophet. Don't self-announce yourself to be a prophet. But all of us can operate in the spirit of prophecy if we testify about Jesus according to Revelation chapter 19, 10. And I'm just telling you, we're about to turn this thing up. And when we give God this prayer, hey, I see it dropping on y'all already. When we give God this praise, God's about to turn you on. And he's about to activate you in the gifts of the Holy Ghost. If you've been praying that way, lift your hands and start praying like you've been praying in secret. Come on.
Praise it!
tongue. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. Pray like you've been praying in secret. Pray like you need to pray in the secret. That's it. Pray past your flesh. Pray past your tiredness. Pray till you can't feel yourself no more. Pray until you feel nothing but His glory. Pray until you feel nothing but His power. Pray until you feel nothing but breakthrough. Pray until you feel nothing but goosebumps. That's it, Christian. That's it, man. That's it, Tone. That's it. Hey, hit a masha. Yeah, Becca. Come on, open your mouth and pray. Come on, this is what they did in the upper room. Open your mouth and pray. Open your mouth and pray.
Wake up, man of God.